The fear of God is when you realize that you are a low-down scumbag sinner, that you are corrupt in all your ways, that you are on the wrong side of God.
I don't need to get laid.
Fornication! Flee fornication! That's what God says. He says, flee idolatry. You are your own idols. Isn't that right? You love yourself, don't you? I've been there. It ends in nothing. When you shrivel up as an old person and you live long enough, you won't be loving yourself anymore. You'll have no more beauty that you can see in your face. It is vanity to be loving yourself for selfish reasons. To truly love yourself is to love God first, and God to put his love in you for God, and then you love yourself because of what you are in God. A child of God, a daughter of God, a son of God, bought and washed with the holy blood of Jesus Christ. That blood Jesus shed is not on you. You're not getting into the kingdom of God unless he sees his blood that he shed at Calvary in Jerusalem. Unless Jesus Christ sees his holy blood that he shed from his veins on you, you are unclean, you are filthy, you are a sinner. You're not washed from your sin. And only that blood that Jesus Christ poured out on the ground at Calvary when he was crucified by the likes of you and me. Only that blood will make you holy, will make you clean, and it's no laughing matter. And no smelly religion will give you a blood transfusion from Jesus Christ. Pardon? If you can, what you can do it. Clone him.
Talking nonsense.
Clone God, you foolish person. Repent of your sins, you foolish person. You clone the devil before you clone God. You're that ignorant of God. You are far from the truth. You're enslaved by lies, by sexual immorality, by every form of corrupt thinking. You're going to have a split tongue like a snake when you're raised from the dead, like Lucifer himself. Did you know that? We're all going to get new bodies in the resurrection of God. Did you know that? You can only look like God if you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Master. You can only look like God if God came to live in your body. You can only look like God if you're totally created and fashioned in the truth, the Word of God. But you are created and fashioned in the lies of the devil. The heart of man is deceitful above all things. And you're no exception. And neither was I till Jesus saved me. And you need Jesus Christ to save you from your smelly sin, from your dirty, filthy ways, from your self-righteousness, from your unforgiveness, from your hatred, from your bitterness. You need Jesus Christ to save you, because you will not stand in the day of God's holy judgment when you come as a worm before the throne of Jesus Christ. Because you'll come like a worm before the throne of Almighty God. Jesus Christ will judge you, and Jesus Christ will say to you, you did not accept me as your Lord and Master and Savior. You did not accept me into your heart. And now you want me to accept you into my heart, into my holy kingdom. If you were God, you wouldn't accept somebody that did not accept you. Isn't that correct? Is it not correct? Liar. Liar! You're a liar!
I am a liar.
God, you want to read the Bible more closely than that. God don't love your disobedience! Your disobedience, God will punish with eternal damnation. For you to have God's love, you must accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You must receive a second birth from God, not a natural birth. You must receive a divine birth from God, of God's Spirit. Do you know that? You want to hurry up and know it. You must be born of God, not of the blood of man, not of the flesh of man, not of the will of man. You must be born of God and God's Son, Jesus Christ, where God puts His Holy Spirit into your mortal body to give you power over death. The same power Jesus had to come out of the rotten grave 3 days later. That's what you need. Not some smelly, stinking religion. Religion won't save you from the devil. Religion is all a con. It's a weapon of the devil. If the devil ain't gonna make you a big sinner, he's gonna make you very religious. It is no good calling on a God you never hear speak to you. If you're not hearing God, it's because of your sin in here. It's because of your wickedness in your heart. That's why you're not hearing God. That's why God is out there somewhere. You will not fight the devil and the grave without Jesus Christ, the Son of God, living in you. It is impossible. And nobody enters heaven unless Jesus Christ lives in them. Do you know that? Yes, you'll be plenty. You'll wish you could never hear when your head is flooded with thousands of evil voices from evil spirits. You know that you'll wish you could never hear, because that's what happens when you die and go to hell without Jesus. You'll be in total spiritual darkness forever, because God is in the light. You are not in the light because you have not repented of your evil ways to the Lord Jesus Christ. You have not welcomed Jesus Christ to come into your heart and live in you. That's why you're in spiritual darkness. You are children of wrath. You will be punished. You will be punished by God. You, the people, for your sin, for your rebellion, for your unbelief, for every word you speak, you will be punished. If sin is found in every word you speak, you cannot take away your sin. A Catholic priest cannot absolve your sin. Only Jesus Christ alone can take the sin out of your mind, out of your heart. Only Jesus Christ Himself can deliver you from evil that is in your belly, that is in your mind, that is in your heart. Only Jesus Christ. I hope it's a sensible question.
To be a good Christian, can I pray alone and not go to church? Or can I go to church and not pray?
Listen, you've got to do both. Right? And you, to be a Christian, you must be born again of the Holy Spirit. There's lots of people who think they're Christians, but they're not born again of the Holy Spirit, so they are not Christians. Catholics are not Christians. They don't know God. God doesn't live in them. They don't have eternal life? Never. You need Jesus. You're a wicked man. You are wicked. I don't want any of your rubbish beer. You need Jesus. You're an antichrist. I've seen you before. You've seen me before. You're an antichrist. Yes, tell you your own words. You will share in the devil's destruction. We are not all God's children.
None of us are.
We are not all God's children. Read the Bible. Read Romans chapter 8. We are all created by God. But we are not all God's children. Only God's children.
Who put you to this country?
Are those.
Who put you to this country?
Who put you?
Talk to me, neighbor.
Who put you to this
country? Who brought you here?
Who put him into this country?
What kind of question is that? Let the guy speak.
Thank you. Bless you for once.
God's children are those who have accepted the Son of God as their Lord and Master, and who have received the Holy Spirit of God to give them life, to give them eternal life. You're not.
You're not. I know you're not. Well, you're not born again. I know you're not.
He's a big boy.
You're not born again.
He's a big.
You're not born again.
Were you there?
The he's a big. You're not born again.
No, he's a big.
He's a mess.
He's a big. Oh, he's a big. Too big to be born again.
Do you make money out of religion?
God's a wicked.
They make a lot of money.
What kind of a stupid question? They make a lot of money in the Bible. They make a lot of money. Mind your own business. They make a lot of money. A lot of money in the Bible. My name's Steve from England. They make a lot of money. You need to repent, mister. You need to repent. You need to repent!
You yell too much!
You're talking rubbish!
You yell too
you're
much!
You're talking rubbish! I have no religion! Oh, yeah. I'm not here talking about stinking religion. I'm talking about, I am anti-sin, like Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is anti-sin. You must be righteous to enter the kingdom of God.
That's why I switched a lot.
You must be righteous. You must have God's righteousness. Your own righteousness won't do. Your own self-justification won't do. You must have the righteousness of Jesus Christ to enter the kingdom of God. I'm glad I'm not going to hell with the likes of you.
I'll see you in hell.
I'm glad God has delivered me from the natural man who is full of emptiness. I am full of deceit, full of curses and hate and bitterness and rebellion against God. I'm glad God has delivered me from the life of
evil. I have a boss.
Praise God. You need the mind of Almighty God to think like God.
Where is it?
And you certainly don't have God's mind.
Where is it?
The natural mind.
Where is God?
Is hostile to God. The natural mind of man is in unity with religion. The natural mind of man is in unity with the devil. And you don't have to come to the same rubbish every time. Praise God.
Come on, give over my baby. What's the fucking problem?
Aim the ground.
You can't
don't pull think I'm going to be tempted by a kick can.
You don't want it?
Hey, God brings out in our
country. I have eternal life. I have God's gift inside me, eternal life. That's what I got. That's what I want you to have. That's what Jesus wants you to have, eternal life, so that you will not die.
Hey, vodka.
You need Jesus.
You don't even want vodka.
I want you to have eternal life. That's what Jesus wants you to have. That's what Jesus died for and rose again for, to give all those who will accept him as the Lord, to give them eternal life. now! It's too late when you die. You need Jesus.
What are you going to get for? You got here. Keep going, man.
You don't want to be a big man for the devil. You want to be a mighty man.
You're a big man for God.
You want to be a big man for God with a big heart. You need to ask Jesus to forgive you and come into your body. And he will give you eternal life. And you will never die. Jesus said these words. He that believes in Jesus, though he were dead, yet will he live. And whosoever lives and believes in Jesus Christ will never die. You'll never die when God and his son Jesus and the Holy Spirit come into your body. You will have Jesus' power over the devil, over sin, over death.
Praise God!
Please stop being robbed of eternal life! Please call on Jesus Christ right now!
Call 911
to save you from sin!
You
to save
sin.
You from being punished with the
God
wicked.
God bless you.
God's wrath is coming.
You're the wrath of God.
As soon as the Antichrist takes power in Europe,
the Antichrist.
Within 3.5 years after that, God's wrath will come from the earth. 21 outpourings of God's wrath. 21 outpourings of God's wrath. For all the Christ haters, all the Christ rejectors, all who love sin and hate holiness.
What's wrong with sin?
You love sin, you will die in your sin. Without Jesus, you will never see heaven. You're going to be around for eternity. You're going to be around for eternity. Have a body like a worm that crawls on its belly with a snake's tongue. You will be totally a child of the devil. You will not have a glorious body of fire and power and truth and a face brighter than the sun. Your eyes will not be blazing fire like Jesus, like God. You will not be in
the
angel.
Are you mad? That's what you need to die.
All you who die without Jesus Christ, you will not be in the image of Jesus, the image of God.
You need a man.
You need to get saved.
You need to get saved. 15 pounds.
You need to make Jesus your Lord. You need to make him your Lord. You need God's power in your body like I have to overcome your death. I'm telling you the truth. There'll be no one there to help you the hour of your death.
You need divine power
from God in your body to overcome death. You're so blind and deceived, you don't know you're connected to the devil on the inside. You are connected to the devil in your spirit. You are connected to the devil in your mind. Do you hear me? You're connected. You have the devil's spirit, the spirit of death and disobedience, the spirit of rebellion, the spirit that loves every kind of sexual immorality.
Show us the blood of Jesus, then we'll be clear.
When you feed the lusts of your flesh, you are feeding the lusts of the devil. You need to be born of God, not of your parents. Born of God, of God's Holy Spirit, to be a son, to be a daughter of God.
That's called demonic possession.
I will finish with this. God is
what,
waiting.
Finish already?
The whole plan of creation is for God to reveal the sons and daughters of God. God, with the blood of his son Jesus at Calvary.
Amen.
Get saved. You need to repent. Turn from your sin. Turn to Jesus Christ. No religion can save you. Only Jesus Christ can save you. Get saved. Receive eternal life.
All right, listen, we don't have to get to that stage. We can get right with God. It only takes you to believe. It's not some magic wonder trick, Harry Potter rubbish. It's up to you to believe in the living God. Why don't you believe, people? Why don't you? Another question. 24 hours of your life, 24 hours a day, how much do you spend alone with God? Do you see the devil has done his job, hasn't he? He's occupied every minute of your day taking your mind of heavenly things and keeping your mind on the things of this world. And what does he use? The cares of the world, eh? Your children giving you problems, your bills, eh? An addiction problem you have, eh? Pointing fingers, watching soap operas. Every minute of the day, the devil has stolen your time that you can perhaps take the seed of life.
You are not created by God.
The seed of life.
From the monkey.
Harry.
Are you a monkey on your mother's side or your
father? Walter. Please, my friend. Give me a break. Where's your head today?
That people have never even heard of Jesus. That people have never even heard of Jesus. And your God ain't God, ignorant God. There's no bad people in hell.
You will go to hell.
And fail.
You know that?
He has failed. Not our fault. It's not her fault. It's your God's fault. I think ignorant, stupid, moronic, useless. Turns out, he's not going to this world. You think he's not going to hell. If he or she goes to burn in hell.
Hey, Bernard, hell is on it.
Sort him out.
That's
a sort him out. Him.
What was that guy doing? What was that guy doing?
No, daughter, calm me down.
All right, I want your attention. Shut up, you mendicant. You have come into a meeting where God is being exalted, and you can't take it. Come on over. Hallelujah, brother. Hallelujah. That's very obvious.
I told him.
You're out of order.
Yeah, okay, that was good. Yeah, that was good.
You're out of order.
That's right.
Now, let's have some love here.
So are you, my friend.
Let's all right now face Mecca and just pray to Allah. Nothing happened, did it? Now let's face the north, south, and west and pray to God. And you're going to feel the presence of God. Hallelujah. Brother, you about ready? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Love Fest. My twin brother's here. Some of you are going to say, he's not your twin brother, but he is. We both have the same father. Come on, bro. Come on, brother.
I got in my hand the Word of God, and I believe that if you read this book, something is going to happen in your life.
I believe it too.
I believe God loves every one of us.
Amen.
That's why the Bible tells us, for God so loved you and I. You might be coming from different planets. You might be coming from America or China or Japan or whatever you're coming from. It is written in the Bible, for God so loved you that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever will believe and trust in the Son of God should not perish but have everlasting life. I want you to know today, it is written in the Bible, God has promised a finicky of eternity in You can believe in him. You know, my friend, you can go to Burger King. You buy whatever you want to buy. And it takes energy to eat that food. But it won't take you anything to believe and trust in the Creator who loves you, who sent his Son, Jesus Christ, to die for your sin.
Nobody can die for your
sin. Aren't you so glad today that you are alive? Excuse me, sir. You know, you and I have got different beliefs.
No, I have no belief.
You're a Muslim and a Christian.
No, I'm a communist.
And according to the Muslim, you don't believe that Jesus died on the cross. But I can ask you one question, sir. Will you shut up?
No!
Ladies and gentlemen, Jesus is the Son of God.
No!
Jesus is the light of the world. Praise God.
I don't know.
My friend, if you're looking for love today, the best love that you can ever have,
find a woman.
Will you shut up? Don't interfere with my meeting, sir. I got beautiful audience.
Oh,
look at them.
They're all dead. They're all burned to death.
But you got a sad face.
Yeah, I'm a communist.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jesus is the light of the world.
We don't care anymore.
Jesus is the Son of God.
Why you let me talk?
He is the Messiah. He is the Savior.
Okay, what's your problem?
My problem is, you need to be born again.
Now I have to be born the first time.
Your problem is, your sin needs to be forgiven. You're a sinner, and you're on your way to eternal destruction. That is why Jesus came to die for the sins of mankind.
Nobody can die for somebody else's sin.
Well, my friend, you're talking like that because you don't believe in the Bible.
I do the Bible.
You don't.
I do.
They do have the Bible.
How can you believe in the Bible? My friend, you ancestors used to worship cows. How can you believe in the Bible?
I believe in Bible.
Jesus is the Savior of this world.
Can I have my money back?
Without Jesus, you can never go to heaven.
Oh, I don't want to go to heaven.
Without Jesus, you can never understand what's going on.
I wouldn't know anybody there anyway.
Me neither.
That is the way that God wants you. Then, must I take the mind of all the religions?
Religion as you are.
What do you mean by being narrow-minded? I'll tell you what you mean. He's me. I must do my own thing and also believe in God. So all right. I'll go to God when I feel like it. And when I feel like it, I'll do my own thing. And God will be pleased. That they are right with God. The hour is your appointed time, no one knows.
So do South Africans go to heaven? I just wanted to know.
Ask if you go to heaven.
My friend, I'm from Soweto. If white South Africans are going to heaven, then I know they're going to be a place in hell. I don't want to go anywhere.
You, your mind, the word of God, and my soul. You must have the Holy Spirit living in you, born for the word of God. And he will purge your heart more and more and more pure watching Father. And God will talk to you through his word. And Jesus said, my words, they are spirit, the Holy Spirit, and their life, and eternal life. And Jesus said, all those who call on him will be saved from sin, from the devil, from death. Yeah? Well, 15 years ago, Jesus came to me with my body. My chest expanded. It's not from body, but my chest expanded. Expanded.
My friend,
If you don't want to go to church, make sure you're going again. Make sure everything lines up with the word of God. Yes, you have to see. You have to know God and His word. His God is in His word, right? In the beginning was the word of God. Was that God and the word of God?
Because when I walk the streets, I meet people in doorways, stuff like that. And I have one. Just about. Just about.
Anything
to
stop going for organics is just a contract. We don't need any contracts.